Hello and welcome to another Channel Fireball Legacy video. I'm Vince, also known as Pleasant Kenobi on the internet, the milkiest of milk fathers, the best beard in esports entertainment. I'm like Andrea Mengucci, but I'm way worse at the game, but much better looking. Today, this is a deck called Waste Not Storm by Ape of Justice. I've played many a variant of Waste Not Storm in other formats, in Modern, for example. And the decks, they felt powerful at times. This version gets to play Lion's Eye Diamond with Echo of Aeons. But before I get into that, just want to mention a few things. This video is, of course, brought to you by channelfireball.com, and in particular, U-Box We Buy, the easiest way to sell your Magic cards. Just throw them in a box, and CFP will do all the sorting, the grading, the pricing, and you get your cash fast and easy. If you go to channelfireball.com/U-Box We Buy, should be a link in the description below as well, and use my code. Use the code Kenobi, K-E-N-O-B-I, to help support me, the channel, and let me know that I sent you to the Wii Box We Buy, or U-Box We Buy. We don't box it, you box it. You box it and we'll buy it, coming from channelfireball.com. Right, so this is a deck submitted by a patron. I sometimes play a deck submitted by some of my patrons over on the Discord, on the Patreon. This is a deck that Ape has been going on about saying is good, and I should play it because I enjoyed the modern variants of it. Essentially, the idea is that you want to get a Waste Not into play and then make your opponent discard cards. It's pretty much that simple. What Waste Not says is that whenever an opponent discards a card that is a creature, you get a 2/2 black zombie. If it's a land, you get 2 black mana, and if it's a non-land, non-creature card, you draw a card. So you're always getting something out of it. And use that mana and that card draw to turn on an engine, eventually using things like Lotus Petals to allow you to cast Burning Wishes, and then use Burning Wishes, you'll get Tendrils of Agony and kill them. Of course, there is an option of emptying the Warrens if you can't quite get the Tendrils mana. There's also an option of just making a lot of 2/2s and hitting them with it, but I think that's probably going to be less effective in Legacy. The deck's actual interaction, so we have 3 copies of Thoughtseize, we have 3 copies of Cabal Therapy and 4 copies of Him as our primary hand disruption. Of course, Burning Inquiry, you might remember from such hit modern decks that made everyone upset, as the Hollow One deck back when Faithless Looting was around. Each player draws 3 cards and then discards 3 cards at random. This can also upset your opponent's hand. The other thing you can do is force a mulligan by casting Echo of Aeons very early, usually by cracking a Lion's Eye Diamond to discard your entire hand, and then discarding the Echo of Aeons that was in the hand, and then using the 3 mana from the Lion's Eye Diamond to draw 7, shuffling graveyards in. This is good at disrupting your opponent if they're on like Dredge or something, by getting their graveyard back into their library, but it also gives you 7 cards to play with. And when you're playing Lion's Eye Diamonds and Lotus Petals and Dark Rituals and Rite of Flames and other things that generate mana, you can easily like pop off when you draw your 7 to try and get your opponent. If you have a Waste Not in play and we get to draw 7 and then hit a discard spell afterwards, which then generates mana and card draw, we just keep going. It creates the engine, essentially. Abe quite clearly said in the notes that Veil of Summer is good against this deck, because a green instant that makes you hexproof and blue and black spells is pretty good against Thoughtseize, Cabal Therapy, and Him to Turok, and against Tendrils of Agony, for that matter. I'm observing right now that Khan is probably a problem because we've got Lion's Eye Diamonds and we're going to need them for part of our game plan. The big enemy I think we're going to have with this deck is me. I am not a Storm player. I do enjoy playing degenerate decks, especially in videos, because they're quite fun to put out and talk about with the community and see the reaction to dumb combos. But I'm much more of a fair, mid-range, toolboxy, creature-based deck player. So I am not one of these people who constantly does well with Tez or Ant or any of that crap. If you're watching this for the first time, you don't know who I am, by the way. If you're looking for like pro players, I'm not a pro. I do professionally play Magic and talk about Magic and have fun with Magic, but I'm not, you know, stomping the pro tour like some other Channel Fireball names like LSV and Martin User and stuff like that. So I'm here to have fun. I know, it's a weird and novel concept in the modern age. But like I said, don't forget, check out the link below if you want to try the U-Box We Buy. Use the code Kenobi. And with that all out of the way, I guess it's time to fail miserably, spin some wheels, and complain the deck is bad when I lose. Because it can't possibly be me or my abilities. It's got to be the deck. We've won the die roll in round 1. I would love to play first. Let's see what we got out of this. We got 1 Lander, Therapy, Burning Inquiry, Burning Inquiry. We've got an Echo of Aeons in hands. If we find a Lion's Eye Diamond, we can Echo, which doesn't seem all that exciting. I feel like we need something more than this. But I am new to this deck as well, so I could be talking complete nonsense. Hmm. I'm gonna mulligan this. Doesn't do enough. Okay, this hand doesn't do a whole lot either. We've got a load of mana. Guess we can go get an Echo of Aeons. So we can go Mountain, make two mana with Burning Wish, Player Lion's Eye Diamond, Petal, Dark. I guess we have to go get an Echo turn two. Let's keep this. Let's put the mountain on the bottom and fold to Wasteland, right? I mean, resetting with an Echo ain't great. It doesn't do us anything. It doesn't get us any further, but it's probably better than... I should probably play this Badlands. It's probably better than doing nothing. Now, I could Echo... I could Burning Wish for an Echo now. But then my Storm count is lower. Yeah, let's do some stuff now, just in case we get hit with a Chalice of the Void or Trinisphere from our opponent. So grab Echo of Aeons there. We're going to go cast a Petal. Cast a Lion's Eye Diamond. Do we Echo now? I guess we do. Let's make three black. If they have Force of Will, we'll feel slightly sad. Let's create this a 3 blue. Cast an Echo. Gonna keep maybe a blue in our pool? No, we'll keep blacks in our pool because if we get Waste Knot and like Hand Disruption. Okay, we've redrawn our hand again. We've got three black in our pool. We can go Lotus Petal. Lion's Eye Diamond. I feel like I'm just spinning my wheels blindly and it's not getting me very far. I guess we want to go red, Rite of Flame. This would make us two red here. Cast Burning Inquiry and see what we find. We got a Hymn and a Dark Ritual, which is never really where we wanted to be. They had a Force of Will there, just so everyone knows, that they discarded to the Burning Inquiry. We're going to... draw three, discard three again. Trying to find that Waste Knot, essentially. Oh, wow. Okay, I'll take it. We just literally spat around on the spot, drinking a little bit of Ribena, and our opponent scooped it up. Okay. So they're an Astrolabe, Snow, Force of Will deck. Don't think I want ley lines for that. I don't think I sideboard anything in, honestly. I want access to all this stuff. Like, Echoing Truth and Hercule's Recall are good against the Chalice decks, I think. Ley lines obviously good against any deck where we don't want to put things in their yard. Beyond that, all of these are targets for our Burning Wish, so we're just going to leave it. I was literally about to pass the turn back. They're going to have seven cards and I was going to have two. I'd failed to really gain any momentum after just, like, I don't know, spinning plates for 5 minutes, and they quit out of the game, so I'll take it. Okay. What the hell do I do with this? Not a whole lot. I think I have to scoop this into a six. Yeah, this isn't playable. What does this hand do? We don't have a red source. This is real bad. Can't cast our Hymn. Can't activate our Cephalic Colosseum. And can't cast any of our spells. I'm going to mulligan this too. Okay. That's bottom a Ritual and a Burning. Actually, cancel. Bottom two Burning Wishes? No, let's bottom a Ritual and a Burning Wish. That way we can eventually cast a Burning Wish. Let it get forced and cast another one. We might just be echoing our hand back to seven again, which is pretty bad when our opponent has progressed their board state. I'm not saying it's good to just do random draw sevens on turn one anyway. It's not a good place to be. I'd rather cast a Waste Knot and make our opponent discard some stuff, but sometimes you just don't get that option. We're going to have to draw a Cabal Therapy, which is actually a really good first turn draw. Do we think they're a Wasteland deck? There's a possibility. It's Astrolabe. They can do whatever the hell they want, right? Let's grab an underground seed. So we've got Blue Mana for our beloved Echo. And we're going to Cabal Therapy them. Evidently, they don't have an Astral Label. They would have cast it. They just cast Ponder. Let's just name Force of Will for the moment. Oko, Oko, Brainstorm, Astrolabe. Bad times. God, I wish I had named. Well, actually, Astrolabe isn't really that much of an issue. If we draw a Waste Knot, we're close to being able to Cabal Therapy them again. Oko can't change a Waste Knot. They don't have interaction. We saw the Misty. There's one card in the hand we don't know. We drew a Burning Inquiry. I'm going to go Bloodstained Mire, crack it for a Badlands. And I'm going to go blue-red here and cast a Burning Wish. Now, there's an argument, I guess, to trying to ritual out a load of goblins to start putting some pressure on is an option. But honestly, if they play Oko next turn, make a food, then turn the food into an elk, we're never pressuring them without Empty the Warrens. So I guess I just grab Echo. It doesn't feel good. It does not feel good. There's also Infernal Contract, which we can cast next turn. Okay, I'm going to grab Infernal Contract. I think that's the right line. I actually blanked on that card being in my sideboard again, because I've never cast it. I've seen other Storm decks on the other side of the board cast it on rare occasion. I'm talking like niche stuff like we're playing. But I've never ever cast. I've never cast in Commander either. I guess losing 20 life to draw 4 cards isn't the one. They brainstormed on our end step. They did not crack their Misty. They played a Polluted Delta, which we didn't know about. They crack their Misty now, which basically transforms their hand a little bit. I assume they're shuffling away at least one of the Okos. Maybe both, because it doesn't really do anything in this matchup. It can elk Lion's Eye Diamond that we leave unprotected as passing the turn or something. I guess it does apply pressure after an Astrolabe. There's an Uro. Okay. Fine with that. We want to draw a Waste Knot, so we can Dark Ritual, Waste Knot, Burning Inquiry. That's what we want to do. So they play the Trop. They got 5 cards in hand. Could be old. Anything, really. Okay. Let's go Delta. I probably shouldn't have played that in case I... No, okay. Let's go Dark Ritual. Let's go Infernal Contract. Okay. Okay. We can Lion's Eye Diamond. No, we can't. Ignore me. Lion's Eye Diamond. We can Tomb for a... No, we can't do that either. That's bad. Guess we're just going to Thought Seize them and see what they're playing with. I don't want to fire out my petal because they can turn into an elk. Although having a 3-3 threat isn't terrible. We're going to Thought Seize them. They're going to cast Veil of Summer to protect their hand and cantrip. Okay. They have 5 cards in hand. They're untapping. They can play an Oko if they've got it. They can also cast the Uro now as well, which is a legitimate problem for us. Maybe we do need to bring Leyline in because of the Uros. Because if we're making them discard stuff, we actually enable Uros quite quickly. Astrolabe from our opponent that we knew about. I'm assuming they suffered the 2 Okos away. Oh no, they play an Oko. They make a food. And then we're gonna entomb Echo of Aeons now. It gets rid of the Uro problem in their bin as well. Let's get a Badlands. Let's go entombing. Let's put Echo in our graveyard. Untap. Draw Bloodstained Mire. Do we even have another mountain? Do we have a basic mountain? We have a basic mountain, right? I feel like we do. Yeah, we do. Which is good, because this gives us more mana for this turn. So we're going to go Petal. We're going to go Bloodstained Mire. Do we want to wish for anything here? Probably not. I guess a Biforce would allow us to kill a food and an Astrolabe, but that seems terrible. I think I'm just going to Echo and hope for the best. And we're going to crack this and grab a mountain first. I just want some mana sources. We're on 7, by the way, so Elk are actually a problem. We're going to light a flame now. We're going to cast an Echo of Aeons. Red Elemental Blast. Okay. We're going to Burning Inquiry. I mean, there's an argument to inquiring first, just to disrupt whatever's in their hand. They could randomly discard their counter magic. I think inquiring might have been better as a disruptive element. Force of negation from our opponent. Okay. Don't want to use this petal now to go and grab, like, Passing Flame seems bad. Massacre seems bad against the Elk as well. I don't think I do. Hopefully, they won't Elk our petal. That's not a thing they'll do. They'll Elk their food and hit us for three, because we're on seven, thanks to Infernal Contract. I've just been grinding through my life here, sacking lands off and drawing cards. If you're thinking this is like watching a dog chew a toffee, that is true. I am not a Storm player. As I should have made clear in the intro, I am not a Storm player. They're going to cast Icefang Coatl instead of Escaping an Uro, which is strange, but I guess this can make, still makes a two-turn clock regardless and allows them to keep up mana. Also, drawing cards gives them disruption. So this way, an Icefang Coatl plus eight Elk is a... the 3S now number 4, the next one got 4 damage on board. And the draw a card from the Coatl is important, but Uro also draws them a card. I guess keeping mana up gives them more options to draw. We drew a Cabal Therapy. This is bad. This is real bad. Any lines? We have no more card draw in our sideboard. I guess I'll Cabal them just to see what they've got, and then we'll scoop it up. Pyroblast and Oko. They kept the second Oko? They redraw it? They don't shuffle it away? That's strange. That's very strange. We're going to run it back again. Oh, no, we're not. We're going to bring the Ley Lines in. Are we going to bring the Ley Lines in? What would I cut for Ley Lines here? Oko wasn't that much of a problem. We can ignore Oko. It's not quite Dredge or Reanimate or anything, is it? I'd love to play first. We've seen a Waste Knot for the first time, and we've got Cabal Therapy. This is pretty good. If they don't have Force of Will, I'm in love. If they have Force of Will, then I'm probably quite sad. We can Therapy first, but Therapying after a Waste Knot seems bad. Before a Waste Knot seems bad, sorry. Let's go with this. Cracking it, getting a Badlands. They've mulled to six, so I'm assuming they've got Force of Negation or Force of Will. Badlands. Make some black mana. Cast a Dark Ritual. Cast a Waste Knot. Does this get forced? No, it doesn't. Okay, that's Cabal Therapy then. I'm going to name Ponder or Brainstorm here, I think. Do I name Uro's Drink it Zombies so I can flash it back? Go Brainstorm. Force of Negation, Veil of Summer, Astrolabe, Sylvan Library. Okay. No blue card in hand, so I think I'm just going to slam my Lion's Eye Diamond now. So if they play a land, crack it, and play the Astrolabe, they turn the shields off again for the Sylvan Library. Now, they're going to keep our Veil of Summer. So we want to draw Burning Inquiry as our best possible draw here. Another Waste Knot is not it. Another land would have been okay. A Burning Inquiry would have been insane. A Echo would have been insane. They are going to play another land now. Misty and Flooded Strand from hand. Two unknown cards. They're going to crack this for a snow-covered land and play an Astrolabe, I assume. Yep, there we are. Any hand disruption. Thoughtseize would be good. Delta is fine, if not all that exciting. We can't just go Burning Wish, get Echo, and cast it because our opponent has a Force of Negation in hand. If they've drawn another blue spell, we'd be in trouble. So we can get Underground Sea here and just cast another Waste Knot, which they kind of need to counter, but it's not the worst thing in the world. Like, they probably want to counter the actual discard effects, but we have more of those than we have Waste Knots. What if we get three Waste Knots on in play and then just cast a Thoughtseize and ruin their day? They're probably going to go my Lion's Eye now. Is that a thing? Seven Library. Okay. They've still got Veil of Summer. So really, we still need a Burning Inquiry. Dark Ritual. Interesting. Do we think they got another blue card in hand? It's quite likely, right? It's quite likely. Let's just play another Waste Knot. God, if we draw a Burning Inquiry now, the value will be insane. They will obviously force him to get it. In some ways, I wish that Ritual was a Rite of Flame, so that we could easily cast a Burning Inquiry and a Burning Wish in the same turn. Astrolabe from our opponent. I guess if they wanted to slam an Oko here, they'd have to put their shields down. They've got seven cards in hand. They've definitely got Force Negation up now. There's no question about it. True Drew of Thoughtseize. I'm going to make some black mana here. I'm going to cast Dark Ritual. I'm going to... Maybe I shouldn't have done that, because if I... they will draw a card off of this, right? I've got to get through the Force Negation somehow. I think allowing them to make little land drops. Sure. So that's Veil gone. Now if we cast Burning Wish... do they let this resolve? No, they Force Negation that. Force of Will that. Okay. So they've still got five cards in hand, one of which may well be Force of Negation still. We've got to hammer through them. And our top decks are incredibly potent with the triple Wasteland play. Watch them like cast a Maelstrom Pulse off the Arkham's Astrolabe. We have to feel really sad. Surgical My Wishes. Okay. That's not great for us, but it could be a lot worse. I'd rather they got that than the inquiries at this point. Our win condition now, though, is unfortunately we can't empty or tendrils out of the sideboard, so we are literally on... oh, no. Mystic Sanctuary Surgical. Oh, Veil. Okay. That's not so bad. Burning Inquiry will hopefully draw us a load of cards, and we need to make zombies. But they don't play a lot of creatures. They got, like, four Coattles and 3 to 4 Uros. They go to 4 here, taking a lot of damage from Sylvan Library. They brainstorm. Jesus Christ. The sheer amount of value over there. They have 8 cards in hand. We have none. They have 6 cards now after casting the brainstorm, resolving it. They crack a Misty, going under 3, transforming their hand. They're basically casting a tutor at this point. Ponder from our opponent. We need to draw Inquiry, because Inquiry is more likely to resolve. Well, I guess we want to draw a Thoughtseize or something first, and then use that to get the Force Negation out of them, and then cast an Inquiry. That's what we want to do. We drew Entomb. Okay, I want to bait that Force Negation out of them first, and then use the Entomb to go get a Echo of Aeons and cast it. Because don't forget, they've got Surgical in their graveyard. They could also have access to a Snapcaster Mage, and they probably with the next fetch and have access to just Mystic Sanctuary pack as well. They flash an Ice Fang Koala. That's an 18 turn clock. 6 cards in hand right now. Uro, Titan of Nature's Wrath, leaving 2 mana up. Hopefully that's not just hard counterspell, but it could be. These decks don't not play the best counterspells ever. Caracas, okay. Ponder, okay. So we know we've got to fight through a Veil and a Force of Negation. Needed to draw any of... just need to draw all our hand disruption at this point. We have quite a bit of it. Cabal Therapies and Thought Seizers and similar. For 1, okay. So we drew Echo of Aeons. Not ideal, my friends. Not ideal, okay. Because basically, Entomb is an Echo, so we've kind of double drawn here. And we still need Increase, we still need Thoughtseize, and we still need Cabal Therapies. any of those things. Look at our triple waist knot, for Christ's sake. They have six cards in hand, two of which we know are disruption. I mean, it could easily be three at this point. They could easily have another copy of Force of War, considering they've been casting Praying Storms, Ponders, and using Sylvan Library to manipulate the top of their deck, and cracking fetch lands. So they're going to flash back Uro. They're going to escape Uro, should I say. Draws them a card, gains them three life. It's just, it's a completely reasonable card. It does not feel like anyone in the design team was smoking crack when they designed that. We're going to get attacked for one by the Ice Vanco Battle. Go to 16. We're now on quite a quick clock because of the Uro. So we need to draw action now to try and force through all their counter magic. Let's go. Colosseum. That is an uncounterable. Holy. We don't have Threshold. We do not have Threshold. We can make Threshold. Just the two of us. We can make it if we try. What do I not want to draw? A Delta? Yeah, let's put that in a bin. You, my friend, can draw three cards and discard three cards. Outside of a Stifle, there isn't much they can... Oh, that was our best draw by a mile. I forgot we were playing it. Oh, that was good. What is this? Don't be a Stifle. Okay, sure. They're going to give themselves Hexproof. From blue and black, but not from this, right? It's colorless, yeah. So we will still trigger all our waste not stuff. We can't kill them this time, but we're not really targeting them with any of our black spells now. Maybe I should crack this for red before this resolves so that I can cast Burning Increase and such. Maybe this deck should have one main board Tendrils. Honestly. For when the wishes get... Oh, look at all this. Look at all this card draw. We're not getting any creatures out of this, though, because they just don't have any, I think. This is strong. They've discarded Sylvan Library, Snow-Covered Forest, and Oko, so we still know they've got a Force of Negation in hand. Him. Echo. Burning Inquiry. Entomb. Rite of Flame. I 100% should have cracked that for red. Shouldn't I? My dog's barking at the postman. We're going to entomb again. We're just going to put something in our yard that we don't want to draw next turn. Look, it's another fetch land, honestly. All this mana. They've got Hexproof from black and blue, so we can't hem them here. So the Veil of Summer has done well. If we crack this to play Echo, they've got Force of Negation. We know they have. So unfortunately, I'm going to have to pass the turn. But on the upside, next turn we go Rite of Flame, Burning Inquiry. They'll probably counter it. Then we can hem them. And we can't hem them unless we draw a land. And then we can Echo. They're going to Brainstorm here. If they play an Oko Optic on the Arcane Master, they attack us for 10. So I think we do get to untap one more turn. So they've gone Ice Vanco. No, sorry, they've gone. What do they do there? Brainstorm, sorry, off the Arcane Astral Aid, blue mana off of a forest. And they crack the Prismatic Vista, triggering the Sylvan Library. They're on 8, so they can actually draw an extra card here if they wanted to go down to 4. We really need them to have cards, creatures in hand when we go to discard them. The problem is, like, they can just throw Uro's Array to draw cards and gain life. And Ice Vanco has instant speed, so it's unlikely. So we need to, like, chain discards, basically. So we do actually want to draw one more land. So I think entombing those Bloodstained Miners away isn't the best way to go about this. I should have entombed for another Rite of Flame if I thought about it a bit longer to make these Rite of Flames even stronger. So allow us to perhaps Echo if we draw another Blue Source, for example. Although we only play one Underground Sea, I think. Yeah, we do. So I guess another Cephalid Colosseum would have been good. They're going to discard and clean up here. We're just going to trigger all our waste knots. Hopefully discard an Uro and just give us 3 2/2s. That would be so hot. They discarded a Surgical, which is going to draw us a ton of cards. Three cards. Oh, yes. More mana sources. Yes. Feed me. We're going to untap. Draw another Lion's Eye Diamond. So we're going to cast Lion's Eye Diamond. We're going to play a Badlands. We're going to make a red. Then we're going to cast Rite of Flame. We're going to cast Rite of Flame. I wonder if we go for the Echo now. And then they circle the other Echo, perhaps. I guess I cast Burning Inquiry first. Yeah, let's cast Burning Inquiry first. This will get the Force of Negation out of their hand. They realistically can't let that resolve, right? They're going to hard cast Force of Will? Sure. So they've still got a Force of Negation in hand. Him then. They're going to have to Force Negation this too, aren't they? Mindbreak Trap. Okay. And they've still got Force Negation. Ugh. Okay, blue. Black. Cast an Echo. Do they have another Surgical Pyroblast? And they have the Force Negation. Yeah, we took too long. We got to a point that they had sculpted their hand to have as much interaction as humanly possible. And now the last card's going to be Force Negation, right? Yeah, Force of Will. They still have a Force Negation that we haven't seen all game. Okay. We could play it out and see if we can somehow scrape out and make a lot of zombies next turn, but it's not likely. That went pretty terribly. I feel like game three, we just got really... We got criminally lucky in game one, and then we got criminally unlucky in game two, in three, so that's just how it is. Okay, we've lost the die roll, but it's time to stumble through round two. I think our opening hands for game one and two of last round were pretty bad too. This is a Waste Not turn two, and maybe we get to him them later. Frustratingly, we have no red mana again. I think the mana base might be the worst thing about this deck, but let's give this a shot. If we draw a red source or a petal, we're in a good space. If we draw Burning Inquiry or a black source, we're also in the Burning Inquiry. So if we draw Echo, we're also in a good space. Maybe our opponent isn't playing blue. That'd be nice. Or we draw Thoughtseize. Okay, let's go for Thoughtseize now to disrupt them. I know playing it after Waste Not is strong, but I also think... Okay, let's just take that Sylvan Library. Those wastelands look absolutely terrifying for our deck. I guess, can we play a Waste Not next turn? Oh, then a wasteland, or Colosseum. I was wondering if we can Waste Not next turn, use a lot of damage to discard a hand and Colosseum them to really start getting off to the races. They're going to play Exploration here and play a double wasteland, aren't they? Wasteland Thespian stage, okay. We want to draw something that isn't our Colosseum. Not going to have a land. Okay, not the worst. Let's go Lion's Eye Diamond. Let's go Cephalid Colosseum. Let's go Waste Not. Next time we can Entomb a draw seven. And we can draw seven. They're going to Wasteland our Colosseum now? That seems bad. They should do it on their turn. If we draw another land and they don't wasteland us, so they tap out for something. I don't know what the hell they would tap out for. No, they're going to take the Colosseum, so the discussion is new. But I was wondering if we draw another land, we can go crack this for three blue. Discard 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 cards, activate Colosseum, and then Echo. That would have been nice. Opponents played another wasteland. We get rid of Loam here to try and get us out from under this bloody wasteland. That's a thing we can do. So, Lion's Eye Diamond. So we're going to cast a Lion's Eye Diamond. We're going to make a black mana and cast Entomb. We're going to put Echo in our bin. Then I'm gonna crack this for blue. This for black or red? I think it's very 50-50 on where we want to be with this. I think it's black, though. Because of Entombs, Dark Rituals, Cabal Therapy. Yeah, I think it is black. It's black mana. Let's go black again. Then we're going to cast this. Do I want to keep one blue in my pool in case I draw a Cephalid Colosseum? Well, we're not going to activate it, so that would be pointless. So no, let's keep all the black in our pool. Echo Vance. We draw seven, they draw seven. Shuffles the loam away, though, which is nice. Should have kept a blue. Yeah, should have kept a blue. Live and learn. So we can Entomb here, play a petal, we can spin the wheel again. So cast this. Cast this. Cast this. Entomb. Oh, could we have Burning Wished for like a load of empty tokens there? Probably. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, we could have done. Let's put Echo in our bin. Crack this for blue mana. Cast Echo again. We have failed to make them draw and discard. This is crazy. Okay, a Lion's Eye Diamond. They're going to crack this for a mountain, I think. Rite of Flame. Burning Inquiry. Inquiry? Inquiry? I don't even know what the correct pronunciation is. I feel like the Americans and the British definitely pronounce it different ways. Valakut's Exploration in their lands deck. Sure, we're going to draw a card, and make some black mana. I hope the card draw is good. Because we're running out of gas again. Echo again. Doesn't seem terrible. We're going to Dark Ritual. We're going to Cabal Therapy them. And we're just going to name Life from the Loam, I guess. They play four of them. Life from the Loam. Nailed it. Dark Depths in hand. Draw another card. What do we draw? A petal. I'm going to cast these petals. I'm going to reshuffle them back in as well, right? By like cracking them. So we're going to make a red and a red. Then we're going to go make some blue mana. We're going to cast another Echo of Aeon. So we've cast all three of our main deck Echoes now. Okay. We're then going to him them to see what we draw. Two lands, so we make a load more mana. We're going to cast Lotus Petal. The problem with lands is that we don't get them to discard much other than lands. Okay, we hit two non-lands there, though, so we drew some more cards. Okay, they're dead. They're dead, right? We go Rite of Flame. So we now have 10 mana. So it'd be 6 to kill them. So we can spare a him. We also have a petal as well. Him them. Pausing. Oh, what if they hit a Veil? Oh, if they hit Veil of Summer, that would have been pretty sad. I guess we have to hem them. This is going to be a Veil of Summer. We aren't going to kill them this time. We're going to make a lot of empty tokens is what we're going to do. Is there a Grape Shot on our sideboard? No. Is this a random Veil of Summer? Crop Rotation. Okay. They're just setting up their kill. Okay, sure. So they want that before they discard the crop rotation. That's fair. We make some more mana. We cast Burning Wish here. They don't know we've got Burning Wish yet, right? They've seen it from us. We'd love to use Burning Wish's ability. We're going to grab Tendrils of Agony. I'm just going to Tendrils them now. Okay, they've seen enough. Cool. Game one went pretty well. Problem is, will they have Chalice in their sideboard? Oh god, I really hope they have Chalice in the sideboard. We're going to bring Echo and Truth, Hercules Recall. We're going to bring in the Ley Lines as well because they are a loam deck. We're going to trim Grim Tutor, I guess. And we're also going to trim... By god, what do we even trim here? Therapies seem a little bit weaker. But they are part of our discard engine. If they have a handful of lands though, doesn't do anything. Let's do that. Let's get rid of those. We can't lose Inquiry. We can't lose Dark Ritual. We can't lose him. My god, what the hell do you get out of that? One Vital Flame? Losing mana seems very bad and something we probably should not do. Trimming an Entomb feels bad as well. Maybe it is a Thoughtseize. God, trimming your Thoughtseize and your Cabal Therapies from your Wasteland deck does not sound like the correct line of play, does it, my friends? Tell me in the comment section below, what the hell would you cut to bring in these ley lines? I guess the question, oh, what the hell am I doing? Do I even want Hercule's Recall? Do I even want Hercule's Recall? I definitely want Echo in Truth, because it's good against Marrow Ledge and the aforementioned Trinospheres and Chalices and stuff. Okay, let's do that. And we'll trim one him, because we can always just go get it out of our board with Burning Wish if in need. Okay. Our opening hand is a Ley Line and a Hymn to Turok. Keep. Put on the battlefield. Here we go. If only this Echo was a Lion's Eye Diamond, be much better off. Because we have to get, be able to go and get the Echo with Entomb and Love Life. They cast an Exploration. The Rishard and Port. Cool, okay. We're going to untap, and what are we going to find? A Waste Knot. Ugh, if we don't hem them here, we might not hem them for a very, very long time, it seems. But I think I want to... Yeah, I think I want to make a Waste Knot. Though I did sideboard out all my Cabal Therapies. None of the Thought Seizers, though. Go and get a... I'm going to get a Swamp here in case of Wasteland. We can't afford to be Wasteland in this deck. It's just not an option. Do we want a Dark Ritual and a Waste Knot here? We want a Dark Ritual. Waste Knot. I think I'm just going to Entomb an Echo as well. It lessens the likelihood of us drawing it, and it means that Lion's Eye Diamond off the top is also pretty strong. We are very soft here to just drawing any red spells. Okay, so our top decks that are good are a red land. So that would turn on Burning Inquiry. What else do we want? A Lion's Eye Diamond. A Lion's Eye Diamond would be real good because they're going to port our land next turn. So we're not going to get to do anything with our black mana. And we can't cast him now without a Dark Ritual. So just more lands would be good. We want to fade them. So we don't want them to play like... Thespian Stage plus Dark Depths. No, don't do that. Stop it. Stop it, opponent. No. Okay, Tabernacle's fine. It hurts our zombie plan, but it doesn't hurt the rest of our plans. They're going to port us now. Which is fine. Okay. Drill Ley Line in the Void, which is not ideal. Let's go Cephalid Colosseum. And let's go past the turn. So we want to draw runner lands, a Lion's Eye Diamond, a Petal. Yeah, basically mana. We need to the long and short of it is we need mana sources to get out from under the port. We are on a clock though, because they are one Thespian Stage away from Dark Depthing us. But then they would choose not to port, and then we could start going wild, I guess. So no land drop from our opponent. Drawing the second ley line is rough. Please don't draw a third. Oh, baby. They didn't even port us, chat. That's an interesting one. Let's go Lion's Eye Diamond. Let's activate it for blue and cast our first Echo of Aeons, which we'll probably draw them into a stage. So we're really hoping we're going to find some stuff off of for our Waste Knot to do here. Crop rotate for a Thespian Stage. Okay. So we are dead if we can't do something here. Well, we're not dead. We're going to have a turn because they can't make the token this turn because they need 2 mana plus the stage. They're going to port my blacks. I'm not going to flood black. Sure. Okay, what does the draw seven give us? Come on! Okay. We can spin the wheel again. Can we get seven cards in library and graveyard here as well? So we entomb. So we play a Badlands. The red mana. We play a Lion's Eye Diamond. We cast Entomb. We're going to get another Echo here. Not Echo in Truth, but Echo of Aeons. And then we're going to go make some blue. Yeah. We now have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 in our graveyard. So we're going to activate this, have them draw three cards and discard three cards. We still have the mana for Aeons thanks to the Badlands and the two blue in our pool. If they discard any lands to this, we actually get mana off of our Waste Knot as well. So if they discard lands, we get mana. If they discard non-lands, we get to draw cards. Force of Vigor. Oh, that's brutal. It's real brutal. Okay. Oh, it's so rough. That was a very good, very timely Force of Vigor. So we now have to... I think we just die. Well, we've got another turn. If we draw Echo of Aeons and like a blue source... Not Echo of Aeons, sorry. Echo in Truth. Okay. Okay. Our sideboard doesn't do anything against the Marit Lage token. Mox Diamond from our opponent. If they play a land here as well, they can actually port us and Thespian Stage. And now that is rough. Okay, Mox Diamond number two. Grafdigger's Cage. Ow! Exploration! This is what draw sevens do to lands. They just turbocharge them, right? Without that Force of Vigor, we were loving life. With that Force of Vigor, we got screwed. Maybe I should have spanned the Echo and then kept the Cephaline Colossine. No, because Cephaline Colossine wouldn't have been activatable once the Echo had resolved. So the things I took was the correct one, I think, but it was rough against their counterplay. Then let's untap. We need to find an echoing truth off of this. And then not have a protection spell as well. We did not. We're going to try again. God, they've got Red Limit Blast as well. We did not get there. Okay, let's pretend we got something. Maybe it stops them from... If they make the marriage later, I just scoop. Yeah, okay, cool. I should have waited to see if they accidentally didn't click the wrong one, but that's how that went. Okay. I guess we do want therapies against the Force of Vigors. It's London Mulligan. We can get another three ley lines. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Oh, that Force of Vigor was brutal. Legacy's so cool for having like actual, genuine, factual like interaction. I would love to play first. Yeah. Okay. So we can go right off for two mana. Apostle of Battles, Dark Ritual. We go up to five mana. Burning Wish, do nothing. This hand isn't that good, is it? We can get turn one Burning Wish for Infernal Contract. Our life total doesn't actually matter, right? That's the important part to remember. They're going to be like mulliganing to stuff as well. They got to be very careful that they don't like have a hand that just dies to one of our combos. I say one of. The only combo we've really got. Mulligan to six, okay. They're going down, 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 down in an earlier round. Sugar, we're going down to five. Going down to five. What were they mulligan for? I guess just Force of Vigor. It was so good for them last game. Bit of confirmation bias there, I think. Burning Wish, Burning Wish, Burning, Burning, Burning Wish. I don't know if drawing four cards here does a whole lot. Four cards is four cards, don't get me wrong. We could also go Burning Wish, get empty. Next turn, we can go land, ritual up to four mana, five mana for pedal. Do I just pass the turn here? What if they wasteland me? Oh, yeah, I'm gonna pass the turn. We played a petal to get around Trinisphere or Chalice for zero. They'd only mulled to six, by the way, not five. So they're on seven cards in hand now. They've played a Windset Heath. They've played a Mox Diamond. No wasteland yet, but if they go exploration to wasteland here. Then we are in trouble. No, we're good. Okay, we've dodged the worst possible first turn for us. We draw land. So now we can go like this is three, four, five, six mana total. We can make a load of gobos and just hope they don't have Tabernacle or Crop Rotation into the Tabernacle. That doesn't seem so good. I'm gonna him them. That's what I'm gonna do. I get two bad lands here, so I can still have a red source next turn if they wasteland me. Him our opponent. Just as a disruptive element here. I know obviously it's better post waste not, but they don't have a waste not. They're just gonna have some Veil of Summer here. I can't click OK on my wands. What the? Crop rotate into what though? Okay. Blast and Dark Depths to bin. Do they have a Life from the Loam in hand? If so, we are in trouble. What if the waste not that could benefit from yeah, they have Life from the Loam. We are dead next turn. Play Dark Depths this turn. No, we're dead the following turn. Empty the Warrens is no longer a game plan that we can rely upon. Lion's Eye Diamond, though, on the other hand, puts the Dark Depths away. So, I guess we go Underground Sea, make a load of Ebrithis. Make a load of black with this. Cast a Wish. Grab an Echo. This stops them from Dark Depthsing us, but it probably gives them access to bloody. Vital force or whatever it's force of vitality or whatever it's called. Three still have three. So we definitely get Echo here. We got 5 mana post Echo, which is not terrible at all. A little mana there. Make a red here. Shuffle it back in. Cast this. Okay, we span the wheel. This is where we got to. We got an Echoing Truth, so that's nice. We're going to cast the Lion's Eye Diamond. We're going to hit him them. Okay. Maybe we should burning could try and find a waste knot, maybe. Are we gonna finally see a Veil of Summer? Or another croc rotation? Veil of Summer. Sure. So they draw a card. Him does nothing. We're gonna cast a Burning Inquiry here. We discard an Echo of Aeons. Wow. Wow, 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 wow. Do we just keep going? I mean, I don't think we do. Because we can't kill them this turn, so keeping going now seems like a waste. We're gonna just pass the turn with a... Yeah, we're gonna pass the turn. There's an argument if we're gonna spin our wheels next turn anyway of bouncing the Mox Diamond or I should have put the Thespian Stage, but then they'll just play it this turn, so. They're untapping with 7 cards in hand, my friends. We didn't get there again. Veil of Summer is a pain. Veil of Summer is a real pain, but again, I do like Legacy because there's interaction. Like, I prefer this, where the interaction is good, as opposed to current standard, where it's just all the threats are good. Force of Vigor on my Lion's Eye Diamond. Oh, I should have known. It's non-land permanent on the Echo, anyway. Okay. Lion's Eye Diamond's gone. We don't draw a lot of waste knots in this deck, have you noticed? We're going to blow up our blue source here. Maybe? Question mark? I think that's what I would do. Less is the chance of us untapping Echo, we could like digging ourselves out of this hole that we've slowly but steadily dug ourselves into. But if they waste them, they can't crop retain to Dark Depths and then copy with the stage. No, they're going to get rid of that. Interesting. Grafdigger's Cage, interesting. Okay, at least we have an answer to that in hand. Waste off the top? No. Okay. Let's go Delta. Let's go Thought Seize them. Another Veil of Summer? Oh, crop rotation. Okay. Jeez, that's bad for us. Thespian Stage, Ghost Quarter. Okay. So, do we have any Wastelands? What do we want to go and get out of our board here? I'm going to Burning Wish here. And we're going to grab... Biforce? Doesn't seem great. It does deal with the Grafdigger's Cage, though. Yeah, we're on Biforce. So next turn, they're going to Ghost Quarter us, which will allow us to get a mountain. As long as they don't copy their Ghost Quarter with another Thespian Stage, we'll be okay. Because they might think we've got more basic lands left. We've got literally just a basic mountain left. Now, the hand that we knew of was 2 stages and a Ghost Quarter. They drew the Wasteland! GG! I'm a big advocate for Wasteland, but it does do things like this, where we are just boned now. They Wasteland the Red Source because they know the Biforce is coming. Yeah. Okay. Bad times. Let's draw something hot here, like another land. A Petal. That is a Petal. I'm going to go hard here and just blow up both of their things, the Mana Source and the Grafdigger's Cage. The next time I can Ghost Quarter my Underground Sea, we get a mountain. The great thing about our deck in some ways, though, is that we get two mana. What the hell? They want to copy their Bajuka Bog with their stage? Doesn't seem good. We do get to... A float of red. They're going to copy... No, they don't know what they're doing. We do get to reshuffle our library in as part of the Echoing Truth plan, right? The Echoing Aeons plan. Or two of them are in exile right now. They drew a Taker. We drew a Waste Knot. So they Ghost Quarters next turn, it unlocks our Burning Inquiry, and then we might actually get to go somewhere. They're going to copy the Taker just for more green sources. Yeah, that makes sense. Allow them to cast like a drawn Force of Vigor, for example, on our Waste Knot. So they have four cards in hand. Okay, they play the Ghost Quarter. They Ghost Quarter us, hopefully. They play a Mox Diamond, discarding a Thespian Stage. So we're now down to one card in hand, which is the Stage. I really hope they Ghost Quarter me here. They discarded the Mox Diamond and give us two black mana, but that doesn't do anything here. Ghost Quarters and draw step. No, okay. Okay. I don't want to play the Colosseum. Oh, I'm going to have to play the Colosseum. They will Ghost Quarter the Colosseum. Like, for sure. We now want to fade them in just drawing a Dark Depths exploration. Okay, fine. They're going to copy their Ghost Quarter, which is a huge shame because they're going to just Ghost Quarter us out of the game now. They're going to blow up my Colosseum. I'm going to use some of this mana right now to Echoing Truth. Well, do I? Yeah, I probably do, because I'm going to end up discarding it. Echoing Truth and Mox Diamond back to the hand. We lose the Colosseum. We say yes. We go grab the mountains in our deck. Yeah, there we go. That's what I'm talking about. Okay, we're going to untap now. We're going to lose basic lands to the Ghost Quarter is going to be rough on us. We're going to play a Delta. We're going to cast Burning Inquiry. We get to draw two cards and make two mana. One of the cards in the graveyard for them was Dark Depths. Draw a card. Not quite where we want it to be, but... Two Waste Knots makes some top decks very, very strong. Like, very, very strong. Play a Grove of the Burn Willows. The other card they have is a Mox Diamond. They can Ghost Quarters if they want to. Do they, though? Take us off red, right? That's what I would do. Well, the Pillow Dale has to get a bad land, so it doesn't really take us off red. Lotus Petal is not what we wanted, but you know, we could find that third Echo. We could find the Burning Wish into Echo. A lot of options. They're going to go up to two cards in hand. They're going to copy Ghost Quarter again. Yep, they are. One of the cards in the hand is a Mox Diamond. The other card is an unknown. It's a Wasteland. Wow, we're going to get Wasteland, Ghost Quarter, aren't we? Oh dear me. That's not the end of the game though. Like, we have a Petal in play, we have a Delta that they can't blow up. They're gonna copy their Wasteland now. Jeez, they should just be firing off those Ghost Quarters. They've got to think that we can't be playing more than like three bloody basics, right? Guess they want to keep one of the Thespian Stages around though in case they draw Dark Depths. We draw a Dark Ritual. Okay, pass the turn back to our opponent. Come on, we want a him, we want an echo, we want just goddamn. Well, an echo would be bad actually. Field of Dead from our opponent. Oh no, this is not what we wanted to see. Cabal Therapy. We know they got a Mox Diamond in hand, so we have to draw a card off this. We have to draw two cards off this. Maybe I should have ritualed first. Mox Diamond. Wait, what? What? Oh, because of what you call it. Because of burning inquiry, the mock diamond's here. Well, I guess I'll just lose then. Oh, God. In the words of DJ Khaled, I just played myself. I just played myself. Red Elemental Blast in hand. So actually, now Echo is like the worst possible draw in the world. They have two cards in hand. One is REB. The other is something we don't know. Probably Force of Vigor. Okay, let's just go with Right Flame. Burning Inquiry. Don't have Force of Vigor. Thanking you. They had Exploration and they had Red Elemental Blast. Or possibly Cock Rotation, but they already used it. Cock Rotation was drawn off of the Burning. Leyline, Rite of Flame, Entomb, Waste Knot, Triggers and gets a Cephalic Colosseum, Entomb, and Bloodstained Mire. Do we really want to draw them seven? Probably not. How much mana can we make here? Let's Rite of Flame again. It's just free at this point. That makes us three mana. Do we have an Underground Sea in our deck? We do not have it. I could have checked, actually, couldn't I? I could have checked. Dark Ritual. Colosseum. Colosseum them. Okay, draw some cards, make some mana. We have a lot of mana in our pool now. We just need a Burning Wish. Another Rite of Flame, an Echo of Aeons. But no red mana. Let's cast a Leyline. We need a Lion's Eye Diamond or a Petal to reshuffle our library. Let's go with Entomb. So what do we want to draw? We've got three Lion's Eyes and a Petal left. So we're going to put Echo in our bin. I'm also going to cast this to go and put... Do we have another Cephalic Colosseum in our library? We have three unusable fetches, three Lion's Eye Diamonds, four unusable fetches, sorry. Okay. Pass back to our opponent after doing not quite where we wanted to be. I think cracking that fetch was rough there. I probably should have unsure. They got a Dark Depth, so we're dead next turn. Unless we can really pop off next turn. And they have a Wasteland and one Ghost Quartz. If they Ghost Quartz our Red Source, we are in trouble. They're copying the Ghost Quarter. No, they're copying the Field of the Dead. They're going to play a Rishard and Port. That's basically Ghost Quartering us here. Man, we're just spinning wheels and getting nowhere. Like, how does this deck win? How does this deck win? We drew a Polluted Delta, but it doesn't do anything. Oh, for God's sake. Like, we can just crack this and not get a land, then we're just dead. We need a blue source. If we had a blue source, we can Echo and stand a chance. It's fun. It's fun spinning your wheels. But, I mean, perhaps a more competent Storm player would get somewhere more than I would. But okay, on to round three. Okay, we lost the die roll. We have a Hammer of Thoughtseize, a Burning Inquiry, a Grim Tutor, some mana. So I'm ready to spin my wheels and do nothing again. So I'm looking forward to it. Let's go. Keep these seven cards. Yeah, why not? Why not? What is our game plan here? What are we planning to do with this seven? Probably just die, honestly. But let's try and have some fun on the way. We drew him to Turok. I kind of just want to... Is it bad that I always just want to Thoughtseize them? I'm going to Thoughtseize them. We've got a him to fill up a waste knot if we can find one. We have no cantrips, so our opening hand is probably more important than giving it credit to. Can this deck just benefit from like four brainstorm? Brainstorm from our opponent to hide whatever it is. Okay. Let's take a look. Okay, R.E.B. Khan and some Dreadhold Arcanists and an Ancient Tomb. Interesting. Ancient Tomb, Khan, and Dreadhold Arcanist in the same deck? That is interesting. Okay, let's go ahead and just cast our Petal whilst they don't have counter magic up. Next turn we can Grimtree for him. Turn off we can him. Sorry, for Waste Knot, then we can him them. Thoughtseize. I'm assuming if they're playing Ancient Tomb, they aren't playing Wasteland. They're probably going to cast Khan next turn, so we kind of need to use this Petal ASAP. Let's Grim for Waste Knot. The next turn we can get Waste Knot Thoughtseize. If they find a land here, which they're going to brainstorm this turn, thanks to the Dreadhold Arcanist, it's very likely they find a fourth land. Well, not very likely, but quite a lot more likely than them just roar Dark Knight off the top. And then they can cast Khan, which is going to turn off our Lions, our Diamonds, and our Petals. Khan, as much as Veil of Summer seems to be a problem for this deck, I think Khan is also a problem for this deck. I would love them to not hit their third land here. And allow us to go Waste Knot, Thoughtseize their Khan. They found the fourth land. They're going to play a Khan. We are in some serious danger. Sure, there's a Khan. What the hell are we meant to do against that, honestly? What are they going to reveal? Tormod's Crypt. Sure. How depressing. Okay, Cephalid Colosseum. Waste Knot. Thoughtseize them. Take the. So this is Grindstone with Dreadhold backup? With Imperial Crypt grabbing Painter Servant? Is that what's happening? Two Pyroblasts. Let's get a zombie out of it. Okay. Pass the turn back to our opponent! So my patron Abe was very convinced this deck is good. But he's also very good with Storm, and I am not. I will not pretend to be. But this doesn't feel strong. Like, I feel like we're not doing a whole lot, honestly. What are they going to grab from the... They've got five mana at the moment, so they can't lattice us just yet. No grab Paint the Servant. Okay. I was right in what I thought it was. Everything is blue. Oh, I should have thought about that with the element. Yeah, okay, sure. Miserable. Miserable. Perhaps I should have took the REBs then. When it clicked that it was a painter deck. Probably should have took the REBs. Do we think they're going to play the Goblin Engineer parts of the deck? probably. I'm going to bring in Cabal Therapy, Echoing Truth, Hercule's Recall. I'm going to trim on Grim Tutor and Tomb. Right Flame, that doesn't feel good. Right Flame is just a poor man's Dark Ritual. Right, there's a reason no one plays it in Modern. The reason might be that's on the ban list, but don't you look at me like that. I know what I'm talking about. I know what I'm talking about, okay? How dare you? Bloody Khan. What is this deck doing against Khan? Like, literally poo itself? Go on then, why not? Let's be a laugh. Let's force them to mulligan. What's them mulligan to 5 now, and I'm going to reset them to 7. Do they play force? They probably, well, no, mana base. No, we'll see, we'll see. If they play force, then we're in trouble. So what I'm doing here is I'm blind mulliganing both myself and my opponent. My opponent has mulled to 6. So they were looking for something. Oh. Oh, it hurts. Oh my god, it hurts. Oh, magic, magic, magic. Give me a petal. Give me a land. Give me a bloody Lion's Eye Diamond. Jesus Christ. We just forced mulligan both ourselves and our opponent, and they got the land. Oh, I guess if we're on a deck which has, like, what, how many lands? Only 15. Perhaps the Force Mulligan plan is not the one. That's a welder. Okay. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. It's all right. We can win. We can win. Draw land. Oh, no. Okay. Well, thanks for coming to this video. I've been Vince, also known as Pleasant Kenobi on the internet. I hope you've enjoyed this foray into Legacy. Something a bit different. Something I hadn't played before. Something I was looking to try out on the channel. Some decks I get time to play before I play them on the channel. Sometimes I don't. I know some people will be mad in the comment section, but you know what? I just don't care. I hope you've enjoyed at least us mucking about, tucking about. If you've got some input for the deck, if you've got some input on how to improve this deck against the current field that is Legacy, perhaps, I don't know, play a different Storm deck, which is pretty a valid criticism, but don't forget, it's fun and magic to try different things. We failed to hit another land, so I'll keep doing my outro. I've been Vince, also known as Pleasant Kenobi on the internet. If you like the cut of my jib and the absolute nonsense that I talk, then you can join me over on youtube.com/Pleasant Kenobi as well. If you want to see me live, where I will talk back to the chat and tell you that you're a naughty boy and give you a virtual spank upon the body, then you can follow me on twitch.tv/Pleasant Kenobi. If you're picking up anything from the channel Fireball store, please use the code Kenobi, all caps or not caps, it doesn't really matter, to help support the channel. Right, everything is blue. We're going to untap. We're going to untap. And we're going to draw a land. We there? No! Okay. Just gonna discard some stuff. Just going to discard Burning Wish. They're going to brainstorm to force us to go longer. I really want to conceive. But what if we draw a land? What if we draw a land so that we can have a land in play before we die? I really like this. The blue-red wishes, the blue-red burning increase, the blue-black entombs. I think it's cool. It's really cool. They have just hit all the land drops. How many lands are they playing? 18? 20? God. Some people get all the luck, right? Goblin Engineer. This is going to put a grindstone in the bin. They're then going to choose to put the grindstone into play. Oh, wait, they can't. They have no other artifact. I'm only watching this out so people can be like, ooh, fun. Ponder, cool. Preordain, cool. It's the worst part of Legacy is when you're losing your opponent's casting like 4 cantrips. Is that the worst part of Legacy? I mean, dying on turn 1 of Grizzlebrand is one thing, but oh, there's an Echoing Truth. We're dead next turn. Okay, thanks for watching, and I'll see you all soon. Tell me in the comment section how much you hate me.